starts with flashing lights, a dark road, ends in a gas station, well lit, two officers, one lieutenant in the U.S. Army. That's not actually where it ends. That's actually where it begins. Where it is now is one of those officers has been fired. Welcome to Escaping the Echo Chamber. Did they jump the gun? Are they responding to public outrage and just cowing to the mob and just hurrying up and, okay, let's hurry up and fire him? Because there are people who will make that argument. There are people right now who I'm seeing online defending the officer, saying, hey, he should have just complied. Hey, he had a loaded weapon in his vehicle. Hey, he's not the victim here. These officers were doing their job, and it's his job to obey. There's some people saying that. Let's take a look at it.
Open the door slowly. Step out. Open the door. Get out of the car. Open the door slowly and get out.
Get out of the car now.
Open the door. Get out of the car.
Hold still. Hold. Keep your hands outside the window. Keep your hands outside the window. Get out of the car now.
Get out of the car.
Now. Get out of the car now. Get out of the car now. Yo, well, guess what? I'm a veteran too. I don't obey. Get out of the car. Get out of the car now. What's going on? You're fixing to ride the lightning, son.
I'm fixing to ride the lightning.
Get out of the car now. Get out of the car now. Get out of the car.
Sir, just get out of the car. Work with us and we'll talk to you. Get out of the car.
You received an order. Obey it.
I'm honestly afraid to get out. Can I?
Yeah, you should be. Get out.
What?
Get out.
Get out of the car.
Get out now.
I have not committed.
Listen, take off your seatbelt and get out of the car.
Look, I'm just going to please.
You're going to do what you're told. Get out of the car.
Look.
Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car. Take your seatbelt off.
Look, my hands are out.
Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car.
My hands are out.
Don't reach in there, Daniel. Don't reach in there.
My hands are out. Please. Look. This is really messed up. My dog is in the back. My dog is choking right now.
Get out of the car. Take your seatbelt off. What are you, a specialist, corporal? What are you?
I'm a lieutenant.
Lieutenant, get out of the car. Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car. You made this way more difficult than it had to be. If you just complied. Get out of the car.
I'm reaching for my seatbelt.
Fine. Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car. Straight onto the ground. Straight onto the ground.
Ma'am. Is your commanding officer available?
Down. Let's go.
Is your commanding
Let's
officer
go.
Available?
Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Get on the ground now. Get on the ground or you're getting sprayed again. Get on the ground.
Can you please talk to me about what's going on?
Get on the ground. Get on the ground now.
Can you please talk to me about what's going on?
Ground.
Can you please talk to me about what's
yes,
going
sir.
On? Can you please talk to me about what's going on? Why am I being treated like this? Why?
Because you're not cooperating. Get on the ground.
Fucked up.
You know this is fucked
lay
up.
Out. Lay on the ground. Just lay
you know
flat.
This is fucked
lay
up.
Flat for me, sir.
You know this is fucked up.
Sir, lay flat. Lay flat.
This is fucked up. I can't fucking believe I'm being treated like this. And I'm fucking
Get on the ground. Wrong. Get on the ground.
Right there. What's that?
It's gum. What the fuck?
Get on the ground.
It's gum.
Hey, sir, can you just work with us?
Can I?
Just work with us. Lay down flat.
Hold on.
Lay down flat.
Now, what I was thinking, I told him what I wanted to do. He said, that's no problem. Two ways we can handle this. We can either sit here with you until you get your eyes back, or you can see, and I mean at a good distance, you're safe to drive, okay? And you're going down the road. Go do your deployment. Go continue serving my country, which I respect and I thank you for, okay? Or we can push the issue, write you tickets for no license plate displayed, and for resisting or not resisting obstruction of justice. I don't even need to go that route, because that route makes the Army get involved, and I know how they are. You don't notice it. The Army, he'll vouch for it, because he's been in and he's got friends that are legal officers. I know. The military is the only place.
Eyes, okay.
The military is the only place where double jeopardy exists legally, because whatever we do to him, the Army can turn around and jam for the same thing. I don't want to see that happen. you're obviously a second lieutenant. You ain't been in very long. But if you plan on making this a career or even 6 years or whatever, it's up to you. I don't care. There's no need getting this on your record. I don't want your record. However, it's entirely up to you. If you want to fight and argue, I mean, and I don't mean disrespectfully, okay? I mean, you have that right as a citizen. If that's what you want, we'll charge you, have you go to court, notify the command, do all that, or we can take time out of our night, which is not a problem. We're being paid to take care of people, okay? We'll sit here with you, get your eyes back. You and, what's your dog's name?
Smoke.
Smoke? That's a bad idea for a bad dog. You and Smoke can get on down the road.
He's driving. The cops flash their lights. They don't see his license plate. It's a new vehicle. He doesn't have a permanent plate. He has temporary plates. It's taped to his window. They didn't see it. They flash the lights. He doesn't want to stop right away. And there are some who will say, hey, what would have happened to him had he stopped in a dark lit area? Dark road, dark stretch of the road. He stops. If you see the way these cops were behaving in a brightly lit where you can clearly see, we don't know what happens if he stops on the dark stretch of road. We know what he thinks could possibly happen. And we know there's people who say that's outrageous, that's ridiculous. Okay. Those are two different perspectives. Here's what did happen. They pull into the brightly lit gas station. Cops, guns out. Show your hands. Now they're a distance away, so they can't even at first see if his hands are actually out. What he does do before putting his hands out the window is put his cell phone on the dashboard and start recording. That was smart. They also had body cameras, but at this point, he has no idea that that's the case. He doesn't know that they have body cameras or if their body cameras are on, because we've seen many instances where officers forget to turn on their body cameras. The officer, one of the officers, gets a distance away, and now you can clearly see his hands are outside of the vehicle, and he's asking them, what's going on? Why am I stopped? Why are your guns drawn? These seem like reasonable questions. One of the officers responds, what's going on is you're fixing to ride the lightning. Now, to all of the people with the perspective that you just obey the law, let the cops do their jobs, question, is a lightning ride part of doing their job? Is threatening somebody, not with arrest, threatening somebody with what sounds like bodily harm, at the very least, part of your job? Is that part of the job? A little bit later on in the interaction, they're closer now. They're trying to get him to get out of the vehicle, and he says, honestly, I'm afraid to get out of the vehicle right now. The officer, the lightning ride officer, you should be. Okay, so now stop, just stop. If you are a back the blue, I love the police, thin blue line type of person, and you're telling the person to get out of the vehicle, and they say they're afraid to get out of the vehicle, and you say you should be. You should be afraid to get out of the vehicle. Now you're telling them to get out of the vehicle. And then you tell them they should be afraid to get out of the vehicle. All of you back the bluers, stop and think what he just told him. Because he's already threatened him with a lightning ride, whatever that means. Now you may say, hey, we don't know. It doesn't necessarily mean, okay, we don't know exactly what that means because it's an idiom, it's a phrase, it can mean a lot of things. What does it mean in the mind of, there's two people that it matters. It means, what does it mean in the mind of the officer? And what does it mean in the mind of the person who he just threatened to, that they're fixing to ride the lightning? But then fast forward to the part where he says, get out of the vehicle. He says, honestly, I'm afraid to get out of the vehicle. You should be. You should be afraid to get out of the vehicle. At this point, should he get out of the vehicle? He just told him he should be afraid to get out of the vehicle. Why on earth would he get out of the vehicle? He just told him, be afraid. So all you supporters, law enforcement lovers, thin blue liners, back the bluers, law and order, obey the law. Pay attention to that line. All the other stuff that you're trying to say, whether you're Gray Kelly, oh, he has a gun in the thing. Number one, both his hands are outside. He is remaining calm the entire time. The person who's most agitated is the officer who's threatened him twice now. Twice now. The officer who is telling him to get out of the vehicle and then has just told him he should be afraid. He should be afraid to get out of the vehicle. But he tells him again, get out the vehicle. He just told him he should be afraid to get out of the vehicle and then told him, get out of the vehicle. Is that part of the job? Threatening somebody repeatedly? So then we fast forward to him being sprayed with pepper spray. He's still trying to keep his hands in field view. He removes his glasses. He's keeping his hands up. They open the car door, tell him to get out. He's got his seatbelt on. He says, I don't want to reach for my seatbelt. Like, at what point, if you are a supporter of law enforcement, do you see, I mean, do you just stop and say, okay, yeah, like, because, and if you're a supporter of law enforcement, do you think he should be told to reach for a seatbelt? Because, like, if you look, his hands disappear while he's getting it, opening a seatbelt eventually, which they're instructing him to do, because the other officer was about to come and open it, and he says, no, don't do it. Like, that right there was like, if he is this threat that he's being treated as, why on earth do you want him to put his hands out of sight? Why? I'm trying to figure that out. That didn't seem logical or like the actions of somebody who was concerned for their safety. Go ahead, unhook your belt. As opposed to keep your hands up and we'll unhook you. Interlock your fingers. We'll unhook you. The go ahead, put your hands out of sight because, like what? But he does. Unhooks it, steps out of the vehicle, and in the process of trying to get him face down on the ground, on the pavement, the same officer hits him in the back of the leg. At this point, Nazario, Officer Lieutenant Nazario, the Army officer, is very upset and is crying. And the refrains, of course, are obey. Because, in fact, on multiple times, he's being told by one of the officers, obey. And so a bunch of people who support law enforcement and who black back the blue, they're just comply. To all of you, do you consider obedience a virtue? Just a question. Just, do you consider obedience a virtue? Interesting. Because there are people who are going through all sorts, jumping through all sorts of hoops to justify what happened. But if you're still, if you're saying I'm wrong, if you still are of the mind that I'm wrong, and, you know, everybody that's criticizing these officers are wrong, and that Lieutenant Nazario should have just complied, before we continue with the video, I want you to do something. If you still think at this point I'm wrong, I want you to hit that thumbs down button. Hit that thumbs down button right now. If you think that I'm wrong, hit the thumbs down. If you think I might, go ahead, hit the thumbs up. But if you think I'm wrong in criticizing this officer, hit the thumbs down button and explain why. Don't just hit the thumbs down button and turn off the video. Hit the thumbs down button and explain why in the comment section so I can address you either in the comment section or in a future video, okay? Just do that and then we'll continue with this. Because if you think I'm still wrong, remember, I said it doesn't really end with him on the floor. Because after that, he's lifted up. After that, medics on the side are on the scene. He's in cuffs. And the officer, the police officer, says, listen, I've been given the option. I've been given the option by my chief to let this go. But you got to let it go. I mean, if you wanna make a fuss about this, if you wanna fight and argue, well, we can charge you then. If he wants to, wait, what? So basically he's trying to tell him he's trying to get him to sweep it under the rug, or else they charge him. Yeah, we don't have to tell your superior officers. If he has nothing to hide, why is he worried about? Because that's your favorite phrase. If you have nothing to hide. If he has nothing to hide, what is he telling him not to just let go? What is he telling him not to argue against? Because remember, because if you're going to say, oh, he fight and argue, he meant like physically fight. No, because he then says it's your right as a citizen. But if you exercise your rights as a citizen, then we're going to charge you. So, do you still think he was fired too quickly? Oh, yes. By the way, this happened in December. This happened December 5th, 2020. Nothing about this was quick. The reason why we're all hearing about this now, the reason why we're seeing the video now, is because Lieutenant Nazario has filed a federal lawsuit. That's why we know. That's why this officer is out of a job now. None of this happened quickly, and none of this was just corrected itself. Just obey. That's what a lot of you will say. Just follow the law. Just follow orders. Just comply. But if he was doing everything right, why was he trying to get Nazario not to say anything? What was he trying to get Nazario to shut up about? Did he realize he was out of pocket? Did he realize he had overstepped his bounds? Because if he's worried about this coming out, how can y'all still sit here and act like, oh yes, he did everything he was supposed to do. The person at fault is Lieutenant Nazario. As always, like, share, and subscribe. And like I said, if you disagree, hit the thumbs down button. Make sure you comment. Thank you for watching this episode of Escaping the Echo Chamber, and I'll see you next time.